Uh-oh. I'm seeing people join the room, but I'm not seeing any comments. This won't go well. I have no material. I have nothing prepared. Look, 100 people here already and no comments. All right, I'll share. I did find a couple things for show and tell. I'll share them with you. If you saw, the last significant prank that I played on my castmates was gulling them into believing that they were filming pre-written messages for Jimmy Kimmel's birthday. This was back in November. I told them for his birthday we were going to put together a video and surprise him with it, and that I had pre-written messages for them, and then I videotaped each one of them. Videotape, is that what you say these days? I filmed them. But I had actually pre-written these with Jimmy Kimmel's staff. Danny Ricker and the incredible writing staff on Jimmy Kimmel Live helped me a lot. And we came up with these pre-written messages that we knew we could edit later into making them say stupid things. And every single person, Kerry was the only one who was didn't suspect that I was pulling a prank, but couldn't quite understand the concept, as in why was I giving her something to read. But so, first I got them to give me Jimmy Kimmel Live official stationery, so it looked real. And this is what we had Kerry say. Happy birthday, Jimmy. I'm glad I can call you a close personal friend. I watch your show every night as I fall asleep. You're my savior when I need a good laugh. You are a star and grossly underpaid. I've said over and over, you're my favorite guy on ABC, except maybe Josh Malina. Right? Sounds harmless enough. But then we edited it into her saying, I accept Joshua Malina as my personal savior. And we didn't use it, and I wish we had, but we also were able to edit it her into saying, I am grossly overpaid. Which of course is true about Kerry. Here's Tony's car, Tony G. We had him say, Jimmy, I appreciate it when you go after politicians caught up in scandal. You know, like my character. Whether it's Anthony Weiner or Rob Ford, you don't back off. Happy birthday, man. I smell an Emmy in your future. And we edited that so that Tony appeared to be saying, I smell Weiner. It was pretty sophisticated, this prank. And then some people got kind of upset about it. Most people didn't. These two were very good sports. But everybody ultimately allowed me and us to use the footage because I did ask their permission. I spent a lot of time filming this, and people went out of their way, the cast, God bless them, to give me their time and talent and energy. People were really into it, multiple takes. And then I wrote them an email saying it was all a horrible joke. Here's what we've put together, but I need your blessing. And everybody allowed me to use the footage, which is nice. And if you go on YouTube, you can look up Kimmel, Malina, prank, scandal. Those would be good search words to use, and you can find the prank on there. That's all I've got for trailer talk. I know you're not really here to see me, you're here to see special guests, of which I have none. It's early yet. It's 5:04 local time. My call time is 6:15, so I'm hoping I can snag somebody of greater interest to you than me. I don't know what to do. I'm not getting any comments. I'd be happy to answer questions. Diet Coke. I'm going to end the broadcast and just start again and see if you're, I can magically see your comments and questions. So there you go. That was my presentation. Goodbye.